23 of Psalm of David. The Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pasture, he leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul, he guides me along the right path for his name's sake. Even though I walk throughout the darkest valley, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen.
Now we're just going to dip out of the historical books for a moment. And oh, thank you very much for the reading. I know you probably didn't even need to look down. It was Psalm 23. And so what we want to do here is this is a lovely way, and the wonderful thing about the Psalms, we know from the last section that the Holy Spirit was with David, and if you like, in the Psalms there is a outpouring of that. And what's wonderful about the outpouring of that, it's realistic, it's from the real world that people are in. And the Holy Spirit really wants to be operating in the real world with us. So let's look at Psalm 23. First thing is notice the Lord is my shepherd. And it starts off, how we see God reflects so much of what's going to happen in our lives. If we see him as a father, that will reflect. If we see him as our saviour, that will reflect. But here, David sees him as his Lord. And from that, he says, the Lord is my shepherd. And the idea that actually David realises that God has been looking after him. God has been feeding him. God has been giving him all he needs. God's been protecting him because he knows all the stuff that goes around that. And what a wonderful time for us to realize in the Bible that is the more we understand what God is doing for us, the more we can spring forward. It talks about restoring his soul. And here again, the idea that David understood that the soul was important, that the eternal was important. And for us, if we're going through life and we lose track of the eternal, if you like, we no longer think about heaven, we no longer think about what will happen next. Our souls are eternal. Then again, we will make poor choices. And I love the bit where it says he restores our soul. It gives the idea that as we go through life, that actually life is not good for souls. You know what? Life on the fallen planet we live in is really not good for our souls. But the Lord can restore them, can restore us to righteousness. And then the idea of I walk in through the valley of the shadow of death, that God, this comes from so much in Scripture, that God is there when you need him most. And it's also that there will be valleys of shadows of death of your life. This is not an airbrushed Hollywood movie. The Bible isn't, and our own lives reflect that. And the idea, I love this where it says, I will fear no evil. Yeah, we're in a world where they say there is no such thing as evil, there's just bad conditioning or whatever. But here, the idea there is evil, and the evil he fears, it talks about your rod and the staff comfort me. Now, if you do the rod and the staff, the idea of something that you're beating away the wolves, so that sometimes God gives us what we need to keep people away, but also the crook, the staff of bringing people close together. And so in those real situations in life, he gives us all we need. And then the idea that he talks about the fact that we have enemies. You know, we live in a world where sometimes we don't think there are enemies. And then it just surfaces a bit when we find out how the media operates or how governments operate. But that's not true here. We as children would know that God has exalted himself above all these things. And then I love, as we get to the end, surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life. And that's not us being good. That's the idea that God's goodness to us, God's love to us, the relationships, the timing of things, if you like, and that the love, whether it's hard love, when we have to be pruned back, but all our lives, just love the consistency that happens here. And again, and finally ending it, that we will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Let us be the people that don't get freaked by what's immediately in front of us. Let us be people that draw on the strength of what's to come. Jesus said he endured the cross for the glory set before him. Let us be people that endure our lives because of the glory God has set before us. Thank you so much for joining us, and I hope you can join us again tomorrow.